Hi, this is Venkatesh. Welcome to daddyscuisine.com and my YouTube channel. I'm going to cook batata vada, which is a typical Maharashtrian or Mumbai's street food and eaten with pav. Batata vada is potato, spiced potato dumpling, which is eaten with bread. Let me show you the ingredient. I have taken gram flour powder, which is basil, 1.5 cup. I have taken 1/2 kg of potato, which I have boiled and mashed it. Then I have 2 small onion, which is finely chopped. Then I have turmeric powder, haldi powder. I have cumin seed powder, which is jeera powder. I have roasted this for a few minutes and then crushed it. About 8 cloves of garlic, which is finely chopped. About 2 green chili, which is finely chopped. This is curry leaves, curry patta. About 2 finely chopped. This is coriander leaves, dhania. About 2 tablespoons finely chopped. This is ajwain powder. Ajwain is roasted for a minute and then I crushed it. This is about 1 teaspoon. Then 1/2 teaspoon of red chili powder, salt to taste, and 1/2 teaspoon of chaat masala. And I have taken 1 small lime. Then I have taken this bread, this is pav, it's called pav, okay, and we are going to eat this vada, this pav. We'll add some chutney, some spice to it, and we'll eat it with this. Take a kadai like this and add about 2 tablespoons of vegetable oil or any cooking oil, just 2 tablespoons. Heat it up. Once the oil is heated up, you can first add the curry leaves. We just wait for the oil to heat up. Yeah, now I can add the curry leaves and the green chilies, chopped green chilies, and also a finely chopped garlic. Add this cheese and saute it for just 2 seconds. 2 seconds, that's it. You don't have to brown it. And then you can add the onion, chopped onion, finely chopped onion. Saute the onion for 1 or 2 minutes on high flame. Saute it nicely. The onion has been frying for about 2 minutes on high flame. So cook the onion until it is translucent. This is nice and translucent now. I'm going to add the spiced powder. I'm going to add the turmeric, haldi powder, I'm going to add the red chili powder, and salt to taste. Okay, let's give it a good mix. Give it a good mix and cook it for just maybe 1/2 minute or so, and we are ready to add the potato. Okay, I'm adding the potato, mashed potato. And after you add the mashed potato, just stir it for a few minutes and then turn off the gas, turn off the heat, and then allow it to cool down. After it is cooled down, then we need to use our palm or hand, fingers, to mash it properly and mix, add all other spices. If that's done, I'm going to switch off the gas now and allow it to cool. Okay, this potato is nice and cool now. It has cooled down. I'm going to add rest of the ingredients. In goes the coriander leaves, chopped coriander leaves, the ajwain powder, crushed powder, the chaat masala, and also the crushed jeera powder, which is crushed cumin. Give it a nice mix and crush it properly again. I mean, mash it properly. And now you need to add lime juice. One small lime juice here. Okay, use your hand, use your palm, and then crush it like that and mix all the ingredients together. Crush it nicely. So I have mashed it nicely, see? This has become very nice mashy potato. So now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to make small lemon sized balls like that. Okay, small one, not too big. So make the lemon sized balls and keep it aside. Okay, do this for all the mashed potatoes. Okay. So I have made this small lemon sized balls of all the mashed potatoes. Let us keep this aside. Now we'll prepare the batter. Okay, I've taken the gram flour, Bengal gram flour. It's also called besan. Okay, and we need to add 1/2 teaspoon of carom seeds or ajwain, salt to taste, turmeric powder about 1/2 teaspoon, and asafoetida or hing powder. Okay, these all goes in, and give it a mix first before we add the water. Now we can add the water slowly and keep mixing it. This batter should be thick, not watery, and you should keep mixing it properly so that there's no lump formation in it. There should not be any lumps inside. Okay, let's do it. So I mixed them properly. Now this is too thick, so I need to add some more water. Add some more water. And then again, keep mixing it. It's done. This is the consistency we need. It should be thick and flowing, not too watery. Now what we are going to do is, we are going to dip our potato dumplings, mashed potato balls, we are going to dip it in this batter and deep fry it. So we need oil for deep frying. So I have taken a deep frying pan or kadai, and I have taken almost 2 cups of cooking oil or any vegetable oil, and I have heated it up. Heat it up on medium flame. And we need to cook all the batata vadas on medium flame, not on high flame or not on low flame. Okay, let's start. Let's do it. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to dip our batata in our besan. Just roll it nicely, let it cover, and then lift it and gently put it in the hot oil. Place it in the hot oil. Be very careful. Alright, this is how it goes. Okay, let's do the second one. Keep stirring it slowly, okay, and let it cook nicely, properly. It will be light brown, light golden brown. Cook it until it becomes light golden brown. Okay, happening very nicely. Wow, it's been frying very nicely. So this has been frying for about 2 minutes or so. It's nice light golden brown. It's time to remove it. Alright, remove it very carefully, gently, and place it on a kitchen tissue paper so it will absorb all the excess oil. Let's do this for all the remaining dumplings, potato dumplings or batata vada. Let's do this for batata vada. Alright, our patata vada is ready. Now we are going to prepare it. We are going to make it. I'll show you how to prepare the vada pav using the pav and other chutneys. Let me just transfer this. Okay. That's our patata vada pav. Patata vada. I'm going to make vada pav out of it. So now let us make our vada pav, Mumbai street food vada pav. For that we need good quality pav. We need green chutney which is sweet, sour and salty. And we need dry chutney which is garlic, dry coconut, some salt and red chili, just grind it, and the peanut, just grind it. And we need some fried green chili. This is fried with the salt and of course our batata vada. So let's start our batata vada. Alright, let's cut it from the middle nicely, gently. Yeah, open it up. First apply some green chutney. Okay, and then sprinkle some dry coconut, garlic, peanut and red chili chutney on it. Some more. If you need more spicy, more hot, you can sprinkle some more. Place one green chili which is deep fried with some salt in the middle. And then comes our batata vada. Just place it in the middle and cover it with the top and press it gently. Here it goes. My beloved Mumbai street food, vada pav, batata vada pav, is ready to be served. Enjoy, happy eating.